you treat me like you do. Well, I ain't no fool. I'm cool, I know the rule.
Welcome, everybody. We're just sitting up here for an hour before showtime. And we are live. It's happening right now. This is just a little a flavor, a little test as we're setting the equipment.
Said you never run around, baby. Said you never stay out late. Let me tell you, pretty baby, I've got to set you straight. If you love me like you say, why you treat me like you do? If you love me like you say, baby, why you treat me like you do? Oh, well, I ain't no fool. I'm cool, I know the rule.
Hey, everybody, welcome. Like I've mentioned here, this is an hour before the showtime, and you are watching a little bit of what's going on here as we're getting ready for the Beaker Street Blues Band to do another COVID-19 sheltering in place. It's a crazy day here, 91 degrees in Franklin, Tennessee, and really hot and humid. Up here in Minnesota, where I'm producing the show from, there are thunderstorms and lightning, and so if everything just shuts off for a moment, it becomes about 8 miles from here where the fiber connects. It is a pinch point, and we can lose it. We'll give it a little taste here, and then we'll be back and do the talking. And the actual band show is going to take the stage at 5:30 Central Time. Here's Marshall.
Why you treat me like you do? Well, I ain't no fool. I'm cool, I know the rule. Why, I'm cool, I know the rule. Why, I'm cool, I know the rule.
And again, as we said, it's going to be coming up here in just about an hour. It's going to be some fun. If you comment, if you go to the YouTube page, and if you are hearing us on Facebook, that's great. You can stay there. If you go to the YouTube page, I will see, or I guess I'm seeing your comments, because Pete Hall, here I see your comments. Good evening from London, and that's wonderful. Chili Falls, he is in Forest, Virginia.
Two of us sang on
and
that.
That's all happening, and so we are just excited that you're here.
Yeah,
it looks like I'm getting comments in tonight from both places, and we are just excited while the band is getting set up. Some came from as much as a seven-hour drive today to put this little show together for us, and you see me looking up there. I see that I'm looking up on the screen. My camera is right here. I can move the camera around that way. I've got a 5-foot monitor in front of me with all the cameras on it, and I can switch between those cameras here on the show. Here's Marshall. We lost
you. Don't care about
Marshall
me.
In the back there as they're setting up. And this is going to be
beside
you there, the keyboard player and others that are shooting. And this is one of the roving cameras. Oh, and it's sideways right now. You're going to hear us fix that.
In my heart, baby, let me be.
Hey, Dave Peterson, the second. Thank you for dropping in. Chattanooga. We're just setting up here, guys. You're seeing some of the back page setup. And we're going to probably put a video on here for a while as we confer. Get some of this taken care of.
Go to waste. So unchain my heart, baby. Let me go. Yeah, I'm under your spell. Like a man in a train. But you know darn well that I don't stand a chance. So unchain my heart. Let it go my way. punch in my heart. You mean to me that very day. You lead me through a life of misery. You don't give a half a damn for me. So unchain my heart, baby. Let me go.
Come on, Holly. On knees bare, like a man in a train.
Okay, and for now, we are going to just let them do what they're doing. And thank you all for joining us here. It's going to be 5:30 Central Time that the actual band is going to start. We were just playing a little bit of it there because they're doing some testing and seeing what's going on. I see we've got 25 people in the one site already. I can't see how many people are over at the YouTube site. Let's see here if that works, if I refresh it. And see how many of you are watching over at YouTube, and put that on. Is that coming together here? We have some other videos and things we want to show you in the meantime. And there we go. There we go. We finally got that working. All right. So I'm producing all of this up in northern Minnesota, and I'm the talking guy. And so let's see if we can make all of this work here. And I'm going to share a video that was from Puckett's Grocery Store 9 years ago that the band did. And while that's happening, I'm going to be on the phone to some folks down there. And we are also talking. Chili, one of my three amigos partners, is out in Virginia, and we are talking as we're getting the sound going, we're getting the video going, and we're going to make all this work for you. But the actual band, the concert, is going to take off here at exactly 5:30 Central Time. So grab your beer, grab your popcorn, put the phones on hold, and you should be able to sit back and have a pretty fun show. Let me make sure that I have shared the screen in the proper fashion here. We go to the Chrome tab, we pick the Beaker Street Blues Band, and we go share. And here we go.
Baby, it looks like it's gonna hit. Baby, it looks like it's gonna hit. Step outside, you gotta learn how to jive and wait. We gotta jump, jive and bend the way. You 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 gotta jump, jive and bend the way.
So I can walk the floor. I got to hit the streets, my friend. There's a wolf outside my door, and the bill collector's calling. And my kids need bigger shoes. It's a good day, real good day. Father Blue.
They might see you, but they won't
hear
you.
All right, so we are back, and that was just a little taste of what you're going to hear here today. And I'm going to see if I can try and get, if I can get, let's see, that should be me. There we are. And now, Chili, let's see if I can get you on. This is a friend of mine. Chili, are you there with me? Do I hear you, Chili?
Yes. Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine. I'm trying to figure out how to get the two of us on the screen without any of the,
I've got horrible feedback.
Oh, what are you hearing?
I'm hearing double.
Just you and me though, or anything else?
Yeah, just us.
Okay. Are you, do you have anything else open? Do you have Facebook open somewhere?
That could be the problem.
All right. Let's get that shut down. Because you sound great over here.
There we go. That was
wonderful. It. All right. Now we're going to figure out how to bring you and me, just you and me together. I'm going to see if I just click on here. I think that just puts you on. There you are. Hey, everybody, say hi to Chili.
Hey.
This is one of the three amigos. Chili and I and a guy named Pete Hall do a show over in London every Sunday. That'll be tomorrow at 2:00. And tomorrow's not my day to get the hosts on, so I'm not even sure who's with us. But I guess I have to flip back and forth between us because I do not know how to just draw the two of us together on this particular. See, if I do this, that brings up everybody. There you are, and there yeah. I are. But there's some of the other parts of the gang members. So,
there's a limited number of cameras.
There is a limited number of cameras, yes. So So
I guess one, five, two, three, is, four, five six. Is the max.
No, six is the max. Six. But anyway, so, but Chili and I do a little fun show on Sundays about travel. Chili, do you know that the 2 weeks ago show got up to 9,000 people? 9,000 are with us. And we're hoping that today's blues show seems to, we do the live show. We'll have about 100 watching here during the show in about 50 minutes. But then over the coming days, it just grows and it grows and it grows until finally, I'm wondering if I can do this. What if I take them out of the room this way and out of the room that way? Oh, look at what I'm doing here. Yeah, there we go. Now we're down to just the two of us. And so, you know, it will grow and grow until last time we did this concert with the Beaker Street Blues Band, it got up to over 2,000 people that joined in. And now today, folks, we have several exciting things. Know that you can't be here to clap and make a lot of noise and get the band all excited, but we do have a tip jar today. And that'll come across the screen, and you'll be able to see it. But that will be here. We go. Look at this is so magic. See, I can put all these things up here. And our host is King B Guitars. I don't know if I should tell you this. Yesterday, while we were setting up the equipment, the owner of King B Guitars sold a guitar. I got to think who it was to. It's like somebody really famous, and now it's been 24 hours, and I was working on something else. It's to some really famous guy, and it was for 1, 2, 3, 4 middle five figures.
Wow.
Yeah, would you? I mean, I'm sorry. I have some nice guitars here. I got one right here behind me. Maybe you can see. No, you can't on that one. If I make it just me, you can see. There, you can see the neck of the guitar there a little bit.
Yeah.
But I mean, I don't know that I've played. I think I played a $20,000 guitar one time. But that guitar was getting packed out and shipped. So I told my friend Chuck, I said, Chuck, go over and take your thumb like this. Just go like this and just slide all the way down the fretboard with it. And he goes, why would I do that? I says, Chuck, your DNA will be on that guitar for all of eternity, you know? He thought that was pretty funny. He thought that was pretty funny to put a, you know, to put your DNA on a guitar and have it go along with the guitar. Someday, right. Thousands of years from now, you know, they'll be able to immerse the guitar in some kind of a laser beam, and they'll tell you every person that ever played the guitar.
Yeah.
You know, and then so Chuck Schumacher's name will pop up on the list. So I thought that would just be really funny. So.
By the way, tomorrow our guest on the Three Amigos show.
Yeah, Cruises
is
for Soul.
Gavin and Luke from Holidays at Sea, which they are a couple of crazy vloggers, bloggers, videographers in the cruise space.
All right.
And they are like me. They enjoy an adult beverage, as I do.
Actually, there's three of us, but this is a little bit like the relationship over in England between Diana and her husband. Remember, she always said there was three in the relationship? Well, there's kind of always four in our Cruise Amigos because our third partner always has his friend Sherry with him.
Yes. And he has Sherry at all times.
Because Sherry always comes in a little bottle, and she's always with him. So
Sherry is protection against all bad things.
Okay, now I have a joke for you today.
Okay.
I'm going to put it across the bottom, and then I'm not going to let you see the answers just yet. So here's the question for our listeners so far. There's today's joke. How do you know they are social distancing in a blues nightclub? How do you know if they're social distancing in a blues nightclub? Oh, he's thinking about this hard. This is a really, you got to know the blues before you can know the answer to this. How do you know that they're social distancing in a blues nightclub? Now, I don't know if I should tell you. just yet. Maybe this should be like a cliffhanger, you know? And about the third song, I'll let the trailer go down below there. How do you know that they're social? Or I could do the pre-show here and let it out, because, you know, we're going to have a whole bunch of new folks coming on.
New folks on the real show.
Yeah, because we're half an hour and 8 minutes, so 38 minutes away from the band taking the stage. How do you know that's your social distance?
See, I'm having trouble figuring out on a blues show, because I've been dealing all afternoon with the South Carolina governor that just made strip joints a major business.
He what?
Yeah, he made strip joints a necessary business in South Carolina.
No kidding.
I'm wondering how you socially distance a lap dance.
I guess they, well, it's a piece of plastic and flexible. I don't know how you do it. I don't know. I don't know how you would do that. That's
and
right.
Then, and then the ladies of the evening have to wear masks. I don't understand the protocol for all this.
No kissing. No kissing.
Anyway,
So I'm going to tell you the joke here. I'm going to give you the answer to the joke, and then you can all tell your friends. So, or should I let it run? No. Today's joke is, how do you know that there's social distancing in a blues nightclub? And the answer is, they're all sitting closer together. See, because like 6 feet, you know, they're all 6 feet apart. Because in a blues nightclub, you know, they just, you know, they're just smoky old bar rooms and people sitting all as far apart as they can. So if social distancing is going on in a blues nightclub, they're all sitting closer.
That was pretty poor.
You got a social distance, so I'm going to sit 6 feet away from you. I'm really sorry. I'm sorry.
Go back to Minnesota. Oh, that's where you are.
Let's play another Beaker Street Blues Band song. I think I've got one here. This is a jump. Well, let's just look at it here. Jump, lift, jump, and fly, featuring Joe Lamont. What a keyboard player he is. And here we go, and I'm going to
That's you in the video.
That's me in the – how did I get in the video? I'm on the wrong page. Let's try this one. There it is. Here he is. Joe Lamont is the keyboard player. They were playing down at Kimbrough's. And let's make sure I have the sound on and take a listen to this, and we'll be right back.
I just see you.
Still? Oh, yep. Hang on, man. Hang on. See, I'm going to back it up. I'm going to stop it. I got to go back and share. I shared the wrong page. See, I shared the wrong page. So I got to stop the share.
There we go. We got rid of you.
I'm a high priced engineer here. You see, share the screen, Chrome tab. How about this one? Share that one. No, that's everything on my page. Wait a minute. Maybe it'll come up now. Does it change? How about now? What do you see?
I see my chat with you. Lynn, somebody's chat with you. Chuck's chat with you.
It doesn't have a blue bar around it. Hang on here. We're going to get it. We're going to get it. This is what makes it real, folks. This is why you know. This is when you know that you're absolutely live. Share the audio, Chrome tab. Here, I'll bet you, if I don't have it now, I'll pay you a dollar, sir. I'll buy you a Dairy Queen.
I hear you.
All right.
Ah, that looks right.
Here we go.
And on my arm is outside.
Awesome. I love those guys.
Does it get any better than that? I'll tell you. I just got to kill that off here now so it doesn't do anything else. And yeah, you know, and it goes way back. I don't know if you know, but this band has been going for 14, 15 years or so, just getting together to play the blues. They all have pedigrees that take them other places. Of course, Chuck and I, you know, go all the way back to the 60s, believe it or not. And through the 70s, we were in Canada. I think we have a lot of Canadian friends that are either listening now or going to be listening as the night goes on. And it's Chuck and I worked together basically from Thunder Bay West, but then Chuck did a whole bunch in Eastern Canada too. And some, you know, pretty well-known people out there, Dougie Day, Dale Payment, all passed on, of course, now. And then, you know, out in the West, we were in a group called the Royal Canadian Downbeats. The new Canadian Downbeats actually followed the steps of the Royal Canadian Downbeats. And these were show bands, and they were different than, you know, rock and roll bands or country bands or any other kind of bands. Played in bigger nightclubs, and people expected a show. It was more than just music. There was some comedy. There was multiple parts of harmony. There was clothes. There was jokes. Guess who was the jokester in the band?
Would imagine that fit your right up the your alley.
I even had a, you know, Huey, Dewey, and Louie. I even had a Huey outfit. except my diaper had a mistake on the back, if that could be.
That's nicely put.
Thank you. A mistake, you know. Man, just great times. Calgary. I got sick in Calgary. We were playing at the Westgate Motor Lounge. If anybody's out there, does the Westgate still exist in Calgary, Alberta? And I'm putting up some comments here as we go along. The Westgate had a double showroom. We worked 3 days in like the beer hall, the bar, and then 3 days in the big showroom. And that was a Vegas-style showroom. I mean, it had a glitter ball that was 3-4 feet in diameter, and it had curtains that came around the band. And, you know, there were tables that were staggered in layers, and it was unbelievable. But I got sick one afternoon, and a doctor came and made a house call. He came to the hotel, and with him, he had meds for me. I mean, it was just bizarre. Wow. And I never got charged for it. I mean, he took all my information, and I had full insurance from America, happy to pay for if there was at the time, I suppose, a $25 charge maybe, but would have been happy to pay for it. never heard back, but he gave me some meds, and literally from 4 o'clock to 9 o'clock, I was well enough to go on stage.
Wow.
So, back then, you know, every person in the band was absolutely necessary. There was no way to, you just couldn't work without the ensemble because watching from the Caymans. Look at that. Hi, Heidi. Glad to see you. Pete, of course, is the other amigo there. And thank you, Pete, for passing around the messages there. We're going to get Pete on here one day when we do this again. We'll probably do this again in the next 3 or 4 weeks. And to get the band together, by the way, some of them drive as far as 7 hours just to come in for this. So it's kind of an amazing thing to bring it all together. And then we're so happy that King B Guitars, you know, it's more than a guitar center. He's got a stage there, which I'll just turn it on for just a second. And there you can see the stage that's set up there as they're getting ready. And so with that stage, I don't know which one is on here. Oh, there we go. With that stage, and the reason they do it is so that guys can come in and, you know, even two or three together, there's always a full set of drums and a bass and everything set up. But, you know, you want to play with your guitar. You want to interact with it in a real kind of a live setting, not in, you know, just sitting on a chair somewhere. And here you can crank it up. There's Marshall amps there, and you can make it a thing. It's an unbelievable place. And like I said, you know, the guitars that are there are not, I laughed the first time I walked in, 'cause I said, wow, what's with the heavy duty security system for, you know, this little guitar store? Oh, that's why.
Yeah.
So,
by the way, we need to wish everybody a happy Father's Day. Most of our audience is in this country.
Yeah.
Tomorrow is Father's Day. So happy Father's Day to all you dads out there.
Yeah.
My offspring gave me a big ass microphone for Father's Day. So now I have excuse my French, folks, but I just say it like it is. I have a big ass microphone.
I want to say it kind of looks like a suppository.
Well,
if I knew what they look like, but the microphone that you have, that's called, I think it's a Blue Note.
Yeah.
But it's a USB mic that plugs in, and it is by no means inexpensive.
No, it's a good one.
And you sound 104% better than you did with your cheap button microphones.
You know, I didn't even have a microphone. I was using the one in my little camera, my little side camera thing.
Hence my comment.
I know.
Hence my comment. So. So anyway, I was talking about Canada. So Chuck and I, when we were just kids, I'm 2 years older than he is. We were all set to go on the Holiday Inn circuit. Now, you as a Virginian must know what the Holiday Inn circuit
is. Oh, absolutely.
It was a bunch of lounges where there was singles and doubles, once in a while a trio. that played, and you kind of went from one holiday into the other. Mm-hmm. I had a big organ, and he played all sorts of other instruments, literally every wind instrument that you can imagine, and some guitar. And we were ready to go, and we took a weekend, and we went to Winnipeg, Canada, where we had been before, because you could drink up there when you were 18, and the law down here was 21. I can't imagine why that attracted us in any way.
No, of course not.
No, no, it's just a bizarre thing. And so going up there, actually, that was a follow-up. What had happened is a few weeks before, we had met a band from Canada over in Grand Forks at a guitar store. And they were in a pickle because they needed a plug that translated a 3.5 millimeter to a quarter inch jack. And you know John, the technician, right? I said, well, I've got one of those in the toolbox in my van. So went out and got that and gave him the little plug. And they said, hey, well, we're rehearsing over at the River Bend. Come on over. Went over there. We kind of made friends with them. Well, a couple of weeks later, we're going up to Canada to see them at the North Star Inn in the pool room. And so we're up there. Well, of course, Chuck disappears for about an hour. So, well, he disappeared at every band break. And then about an hour afterwards, he's gone for, you know, like, and he comes back and he just said, oh, I was talking to the guys in the band. Well, the next day he sat me down and said, I have bad news. I've been hired to be the bass player in this band and we're leaving in a week for Eastern Canada. And so our whole deal is off. I should have shot him dead right there, you know. I should have just been
worthwhile. Yeah.
Probably should have just shot him dead right then. But anyway, of course he had to go back and tell his parents that as an 18, 19 year old, he was going to pack up his stuff. At least they knew if he was with John, how much trouble could two guys from Crookston get into, right? But now all of a sudden, he's just leaving. This did not go well with his parents.
No.
Foreign country. Yeah. Oh, and that's a funny story too, you know. I mean, for some years, I went to work for Yamaha Music up in Winnipeg, right? From my farm to my penthouse, I had a beautiful apartment up there, 150 miles, right? From the farm here where I now live up to there, 150 miles. From the farm to Minneapolis, 300 miles. My folks would go to Minneapolis to see other relatives. My sister was down there. They would make that run without even thinking about it, right? In the years that I lived in Winnipeg, they never came to see me once.
Mm-hmm.
Too far.
Yeah.
Foreign country, you know? But they did go to Canada for other things, I might point out. That's the bizarre part of it. But they never, it just worked out in 4 years. They never, ever came and saw my apartment up in Winnipeg. But anyway, so Chuck got in that band, went to Eastern Canada. The band realized that they were like 35-year-old, pretty professional guys, and Chuck just wasn't coming up to speed as a 19-year-old. I mean, didn't know enough of the music, didn't have the, you know, that was Dale Payment, and he was a cool guy. I mean, he said, Chuck, go back and get John, get the other guys that you had in your bands that he had heard about, put a group together. You can use my agent will book you, and you know, we're going to make something out of your band. And he did. I mean, he did his part. And that's how, you know, 6-8 months later, our little band went up to Canada and had the time of our life and the experience of our life. Ran into people whose relatives had lived there for hundreds of years who said things like, buy me some beer or I'll kill you.
The direct approach. Buy
again for the third time or I'll kill you. We got that a lot, it seemed, in some of the bars that we played in. So, you know, but it was great learning. It was the ultimate learning, thing and it's a longer story for another time, but I will tell you that I've only been in jail once in my life, and guess where it was?
In Canada.
In Canada. 2 hours. It was only for 2 hours. Huh. It was only for 2 hours. It was a mistake. I had not committed any crimes. Uh-huh. It was an over-anxious RCMP officer who thought that he had a big criminal, big fish on the line. And well, you know, like in the Star Wars movie where they're Jar Jar Binks is in this little underwater and they're swimming. They have this thing that kind of like swims, but it's a little submarine. And then they're in the mouth of this giant fish. Right. Hmm. And then they get free because a bigger, giant fish comes along, and then the really dry guy that's one of the Jedi says, there's always a bigger fish, you know? Well, that's exactly what happened to me. This RCMP officer who thought that he was really in control found out there was a bigger fish, who called him up and said, ixnay on the Eitmeyer A in prison thing. It's a funny story. It's a two bottle of sherry story, but I'll tell everybody sometime, but it's not what we're here for. We're here to talk about the Beaker Street Blues Band, and we are now 15 minutes away. I'm watching on all the monitor cameras, and they are, this is the greatest group, because, you know, they're all, I think Chuck is one of the younger ones, and he's 67. And so they have had, oh, he's saying, try this. He just sent me a message, try this, but he doesn't say what try this is. Try this, okay. What is try this? Oh, sent a link. Hang on, I got to pick up another camera. Okay, that's coming in, yeah. He should see it on the screen there. You see it on the screen, right?
On my computer without a camera, it says.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, it's saying try this.
That's in the private chat. Oh, goodness, I'll just pull over to live chat. We got tons of live chat going
on. Oh, yeah, we got lots of, live chat. Where are you seeing that? I meant Mike Welch may join. Okay. All right, so we'll remove him from the... Anyway, Chuck, if you're hearing this, he's online right now, so that's great. I got to get down here to some new comments here. Watching and listening, Peggy Newhouse, also a person from Crookston. There's her comment.
Listening from San Diego.
Oh, my, one of my, you know, I had a house in San Diego, had a 44-foot swimming pool. If you sat in the hot tub at night, it was on the track where the planes came in to land in San Diego. So they weren't making any noise. They were just like, whizzing by. Tell me again, why did I leave that? Okay. And I'm saying, okay. And San Diego is a beautiful, beautiful town. Hi, Peggy. Love it.
To Vicky, yes, the boys will be on stage at 5:30. That's our time. No, yep. That's your time. That's 6:30 our time.
Whatever, however that works out for everybody else. Bridget is saying special hello, Marshall Pearson. Marshall, the drummer, all of these guys have played with every. So what I'm saying about that is they can come in at like 4 minutes before, set up all their equipment, take 30 seconds to listen to the room and get it all. And then all of a sudden they're just, you know, it's like the Johnny Carson band. They're ready to go.
Yeah.
And it's like, but of course, now that we're adding video and all sorts of and audio and everything to it, it makes it a little more complicated, but it's just fun. So. It's so great to have you folks on. And of course, the reason we're doing this pre-show is because we want to get the stream all working, know that it's happening. And that's why I invited Chili on, because the two of us were just kind of fun. Chili, by the way, he had, for years, he's had this big, big ass swimming pool. There's no other way to call it. And apparently he's had it filled with styrofoam crystals or something. But a month or so ago, he got it all cleaned out. He had some real hefty guys come over, put in a new liner, right? Is that what they did?
Oh, yeah.
They put in a new liner and painted it and did steps. The whole thing around the steps and put in a new go bar or whatever you call it to get in and out.
And turned it to saltwater pool.
Oh, and made it a saltwater pool so you could have fishes swimming in it.
Well, you've so desired. However, it's great on the skin.
I could send a shark over.
Well, sure. Why not?
Yeah. Who do you want? Like the guy that's kind of bald, or do you want the gal with the little blonde hair? What shark would you?
I always prefer a gal over a guy, but that's just me.
But understand, you're going to have to feed them. So, you know.
I had a nice French lady here today.
Really?
Really? Yes.
Okay. What was?
And the water was too cold for me. I'm a sissy. Okay.
Yeah. You know, in Europe, just. The ocean's never warm. So like if you go to the north of Germany to go to the beach, you know, if the water gets up to 50, you're cooking hot dogs.
Yeah.
I mean, so they're used to that. But to me, it's like, it reminds me of that Seinfeld episode with George. Remember the one where he got caught by his girlfriend with, just a terrible thing. So,
yeah.
So, by the way, if I'm looking up, I'm looking at you on a 6-foot screen up here. That's why I'm not just gazing off into the wilderness. I haven't lost it. I'm just, now I'm looking at you directly. See.
Hello to Jim from Southern Illinois.
All right.
And Joanne from Grubville, Missouri.
Wow.
Tony from Montreal, California.
Is there such a place?
Montreal, California? Is that? Sure. No, that's got to be Montreal, Canada.
Oh, CA. That's, yeah, CA.
CA.
Now, you know, it's not Montreal in Canada. They have a different way to pronounce it. And I, at every stage of alcoholic drunkenness, I've tried to pronounce it, and they've always told me I'm wrong. So I don't even try. So Tony Schoenfeld, yes. Joanne Purcell Kell from Grubville, Missouri. I don't know that Grubville's on any of the freeways. That's my entire Missouri experience is freeways. So Jim Davenport, Southern Illinois. Do you know the accent they have in Southern Illinois? Kevin Williams, when we first moved to Tennessee, Lori, the gal I was hanging out with at the time, worked for a guy from Southern there named Kevin Williams. And Kevin talked like this. Hi, my name is Kevin Williams. And I said, where are you from? He goes, Southern Illinois. No, I said, where are you really from? And he goes, 3 generations in Southern Illinois. I'm saying, people in Southern Illinois don't talk. He says, they all talk like, what do you mean? They all talk like me. And come to find out, there's a part of Southern Illinois that has an accent that is beyond Kentucky and Eastern Tennessee and stuff. So, yeah.
Well, when you were up there running around in Canada, I went to college in Kentucky.
When, whereabouts?
At Lexington, UK, University of Kentucky. And I went there because they had pretty horses and fast women. Or was it fast horses and pretty women? I always got that confused.
See, my directive to Ronnie, because at the University of Minnesota branch here, they have a whole horse branch. And most, I think all of the people that are in that track are ladies. Yeah. And I told Ronnie when he was in college, no catching up with a girl with a horse, because if you do, there's always 3 in the relationship.
Yep.
3 in the relationship. Up here, one of my second cousins was out running with the man that she ultimately married. But before she got married, she and he were out running across the field, and the horse that he was on tripped and stumbled, and they both went flying. Guess which one she went to check on first?
The horse.
Of course.
When
Mr. Ed said, of course, he meant it. Audrey Winthrop from Sunset Beach, California. Hello. Pete from London, of course. Pete is the ultimate guy. If I could get one more camera on here, we would. But he'll have to trade with Pete next time. So, or else you guys could get together in the same room. That would work. So, take the stage. Did I say that wrong, Alan? The boys take the stage at 5:30. Yes.
Yes, in 9 minutes.
9 minutes, probably.
And by the way, we need to congratulate Tiz the Law, who won the Belmont Stakes while we've been sitting here talking.
Wow, and you know, I had my bet was on almost going to make it for $100. So.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I don't bet. So.
You know, I am not a bettor in Las Vegas. I know how to win in Las Vegas. I can teach you how to win in Las Vegas, but I am not. I do not gamble. And so I consider myself a big winner. Have you been in the Bellagio in Las Vegas?
Me? Oh, yes.
Have you looked up, you know, where you register to check in? Have you looked up at the lighting fixture in that room above you?
Yes.
It's like 150 feet long, and it's huge. All blown glass. It's like, take an iris. One of my favorite flowers, by the way, down from where you are. Debbie Chun, hey, from Nashville. Debbie, we're down to 7 minutes maybe. Blow it up so that each of the petals is, 5-6 feet of, you know, one petal would be a curved piece of glass.
Oh, yeah.
And do that till it goes 100 feet that way and 40 feet this way. That's the chandelier in the Bellagio entrance hall.
Right.
Unbelievable. And I feel that when I go there and then I don't gamble, I'm kind of stealing from them.
Well, they make up for it.
Other people do, though. But for me personally,
yeah.
Best noodles you can get in the world, by the way, in the noodle house at the Bellagio. It's there for the high rollers that come from the Asian countries. But if you like noodles or the Vietnamese soup called pho, which is spelled P-H-O.
P-H-O, yeah.
Yeah. Unbelievable. It's the best $16 I've ever spent for a bowl of soup in my life. No, the flavors were just layered.
Yeah, yeah.
And, I mean, it was just magic. But that's about as much as I spend there. So Debbie says she's waiting. Yes, we are all waiting for different things, but no. What do you think of my backgrounds today, too? Do you see that's a deck of cards all thrown out there, Chili?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then Donna. Where's Donna? She doesn't say where she are. Patty and Joe, yep, they're here. They'll get your message later, Donna. They're all getting ready. Let me see if I can throw some more.
JP says the landlord made him watch this.
Hey, Mike. Oh, and I'm just responding here.
Sorry to hear that. Mike.
Thanks. Okay, so that's all good all around. Okay, I wanted to get into banners. Oop, I want to get into brand. Here we go. Look at this. I can look at this one. Is that not cool or what?
Oh, that's awesome.
It's like it's
you
it's
need
like,
to click Debbie off.
What did Debbie do?
Debbie Chun. You've still got her up paid for Nashville.
Back to that. Yeah, I can do that. I can make it happen. Comments. Oh, no, not yet. Comments. Debbie, there she goes. All right. Well, we've had a lot of fun here. You know, you having somebody to bounce off is always great. Everybody is invited to Chili's after party.
Sure. Why not?
The pool's a little cold, but you know, if we get enough beautiful babes in there stirring up the water,
it'll warm it up in a hurry.
Yeah. Yeah. The champagne's cold. The water's warm.
We had three nights at 50 degrees here this week. And it's cold. It's too cold for me today. I sat out by the pool, but I got my toe wet. That was it.
Wonderful, wonderful. Everybody, please, you know, we're doing these concerts because of social distancing and, you know, where the band usually plays, there's just not going to be 100 people in a small room for, I think, a long, long time. Chili is an expert in the cruise business. And by the way, he can arrange, he sets up cruises for you beyond what a travel agent will do. If you need him, just get a hold of me and I'll get you to him. But with that, Chili, the big announcement yesterday, or was it the day before already? It goes so fast that literally all the big guys have voluntarily said nothing until, what's the new date?
September 15th. And it's probably going to go till October 1st. The Norwegian made an announcement today till October 1st. Carnival's coming out Monday. Clea's the one that made the announcement. Still not sure how it affects, like, my friend at Bahamas Paradise, because they're not a Clea member. So I'm not sure if that's going to affect them or not, because they're planning on sailing to the Bahamas July 25th.
Right, so. Smaller boats, and then even on the smaller boat, they're only going to run like 40% capacity.
Right.
So they just want to do enough to basically keep their people employed, really,
yeah.
And to keep the machine running in some fashion. And they have two boats, I believe, right? And they're just going to start with one. So it's like 2 days over to the Bahamas and back, right? It's kind of like, and so great. All right, well, folks, we're a couple of minutes away. I'm going to say goodbye to Chili Falls.
Okay.
And thank you so much for being with us.
All right, guys.
See you tomorrow.
See ya.
Yeah, come and join us. And Pete, we make up the Cruise Amigos. And we'll be on tomorrow at 2 o'clock Central, 3 o'clock Eastern, and 9 o'clock.
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock, rather. 8 o'clock over in London time. So that should be fun. I'm going to say goodbye to you, and I'm going to wipe you out here.
Okay.
And we're going to click some more buttons and see if we can have some fun. All righty. There he goes. Never actually seen the guy in person. We only work digitally there. Look, we're up to 35 on this channel. I don't know how many of you are listening over on the YouTube side, but we're going to start bringing in some of the cameras here. There's Chuck. We're going to add him to the stream. Hey, Chuck. Let's get some sound on here. Howdy. Have you got a mic nearby you? Nope, we're not hearing you. We're not hearing you. Go to another computer. Go to one that I can unmute. Hi, Lynn. There's Lynn. Chuck's getting his microphone here. Hey. Well, we're seeing folks, but we're not hearing them yet.
We're working on it. We're working on it.
Can you hear me?
Check. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, starting to come now.
All right, here we go. You hearing me now? All right.
We are. We have just had a fun hour. We played three of your songs and Chili Falls. You know, one of the three amigos and I have been chatting up the blues band and also talking about some of the history up in Canada and out in California, great. And we're ready to go.
Canada, one of my favorite places.
The listeners, I can't see the listeners over on YouTube, but the listeners on Facebook is just a steady, it's like COVID-19, just going up and up and up and up. So
this is a good thing. So, well, good. I'm glad everybody's watching. We're getting ready to do the show here minutes away. I think we're... So a couple of last minute adjustments and we'll be ready to roll. But anyway, looks like some people are making some comments here. Pretty cool. So
yes, we've got just lots of people from literally all over the world. Here's a D. Clark. Grok. Hey guys, hey, glad to see you all. Can't wait to see you in person.
Say hello to D. There's Lee McLaughlin, Peter Hall. Cool.
We can just run these all up here.
Oh, cool. Alan.
Montreal.
Hey, how about that?
There's Peggy out in San Diego.
Ollie, come on in here. Hey, let's bring, here we go. We got, hey, John.
Yo.
We got Holly Ferris here, formerly with the James Brown Band.
All righty, a little trumpet music, perhaps.
What's that?
Looking forward to it.
Oh, okay. I hope we don't need bad notes. Those aren't allowed.
Yeah, we'll start here. All right, we're going to, Dom, I'll let you go here. We're going to gather everybody up and start playing here in a matter of minutes.
All right, we'll be bringing the cameras on, and away we go. Chuck, have a great show. And everybody's excited. We've got more people on right now than we had last visit. So,
well, it's going to be a fun show. We got a new look to the venue here, some colored lights. We've made some nice improvements. I think the sound is going to be better. Everything's better. So, little by little. Looking forward to it, guys. Everybody enjoy the show. See you in a bit.
All right, so there it is. I'm going to just start bringing some cameras on here. And so you can see the other places, and you're going to see their backsides a little bit first. And then as they start making music, we can actually choose the cameras that we want. And I see we have... one of our video expert guys on. Now that all makes sense. There's Mike on his iPhone out from California, and that's great. I'm glad you're here, Mike. Thank you. All right, look at that. Marshall, of course, is going to take his set of drums. I see him walking around the opposite side there. He should be appearing here in camera number three in just a moment. Let's see if we can solo him up. These drums have been in more bars, I think, than Grain Belt Beer ever was. And here's the wide shot for you. Everybody getting their last shots of Gatorade here now. That's one thing, you know, as the band gets older, the special beverages and things you have to get, it's down to Pepto-Bismol, Gatorade, and plain chips. So it gets a lot cheaper to go out on the road now. There's Marshall, sitting down and ready to go.
There they are. Little ringers. So anyway, we are had a really good response on Facebook. Venture we promoted, and in particular, man, we've had lots of response from neighbors up in Canada, and that is extremely cool. We've gotten responses from every province. You know, it's been really fantastic, and we hope you guys are tuning in right now. You really enjoy it. There's no sound. Hang on, no one's hearing me.
Ignore the frying bacon.
Hey, Chuck, there's no sound coming through from the PA system. No sound from the PA. Okay, he's got the message. We're going to figure this out here in just a minute because it was working so good before.
Check 1, 2, 1, 2.
Okay, on now?
Yes, I hear it, but it's 2%, 5%.
Okay, so we're back.
Okay.
All right, John, check 1-2. You hearing that? 1-2. Check 1-2, 1-2. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Check 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Sound now, John. Shake your head. Yes. Yes. Very good. Okay. All right. What was I saying? Here's our crowd. Hey! Welcome, everybody, across the United States. I know many folks from Canada have responded to our Facebook invite. That's really fantastic. I think we have folks watching from Great Britain, maybe all over the place, but enjoy the show. We're a little behind. Sorry about that. We had a little technical difficulty that can happen, but we are ready to play some blues. So sit back and enjoy the show. Here we go.
Hey!
Have Marshall Pearson back here on the drums. Sing one for ya, Cole. If you love me like you say.
If you love me like you say, why you treat me like you do? If you love me like you say, baby, why you treat me like you do? Well, I ain't no fool, I'm cool, I know the rules. Said you never run around, said you never stay out late. Said you never run around, baby, said you never stay out late. Let me tell you, pretty baby, to set you straight. If you love me like you say, why you treat me like you do? If you love me like you say, baby, why you treat me like you do? Well, I ain't no fool, I'm cool, I know the rules.
Said you're not at home, so unchain my heart, baby, let me go.
Unchain my heart, baby, let me go. Unchain my heart, 'cause you don't love me no more. Every time I call you on the phone, some big old boys say you're not at home. Chain my heart and let me go, baby, please.
Well, unchain my heart, go on and let me be. Unchain my heart. You don't care about me. You got me sewed up like a pillowcase. You let our love go to waste. So unchain my heart, baby. Let me be.
Well, money is fair. Like a man in a train. But you know darn well that I don't stand a chance.
So unchain my heart. Go on and look my way. Unchain my heart. You know you wear them at night and day. You live a life of misery. You don't give a half a damn for me. So unchain my heart, baby. Let me go.
Holly Ferris.
Money is there like a man in a train, but you know darn well that I don't stand a chance.
One chain my heart, go on look my way. One chain my heart, you know you were a man night and day. Got me sewed up like a pillowcase. You let our love go to waste. So unchain my heart, baby. Let me go.
I'll play one.
You know darn well that I don't stand a chance.
Unchain my heart. Oh, baby, look my way now. Yeah. Unchain my heart. You worry me night and day. Got me wrapped up like a pillowcase. You spread my love all over the place. Unchain my heart and set me free. Baby, please. Yeah, unchain my heart and set me free. Baby, please. Yeah, unchain my heart and set me free.
Lamont, Gary Gilbert on vocals. Oh my gosh, who's singing what? It was amazing. I'm looking over here.
It's our new duet.
It's unbelievable.
He's the OG.
Hey, that's fun. I'd say what. I hope you guys are having fun. We have a few people in house, and you know, our only regret is I know there's lots of people watching all over the place that we can't actually see you, but we do see some comments coming in, and we really appreciate that. It's really fun to see. We'll try to give you a shout out when we can. But I know there's many friends watching across Canada and Great Britain, all across the United States. Lots in Tennessee where we're at. We're just about 17 miles south of Nashville is where this broadcast is taking place. We're going to do a song here that's off of our CD. This is called House of Blues. If anybody would like our CD, you can find it on our website, BeakerStreetBluesBand.com. And also, last time we played, people were asking about a tip jar. We have one this time, if you're so inclined. There's no obligation, but it's at the website also, or maybe you found it on Facebook or something. I don't know, but somewhere out there, there's a tip jar, evidently. So let's play this one, House of Blues. Here we go.
If you go to our website and scroll on the first home page, 3.5 pages down above the letterhead.
All right, here we go, boys.
She was tough and she was fine. Like a hot tail for the night. She took me for a ride and I lost my head. Well, I did not see the signs. You know, a love that drove me blind. Now it's too late. The lights are turning red. She left me next to nothing. Another broken fool. Standing in a cold wind, howling at the moon. Someone born to win the game. Someone born to love. And they spend the night, every night in the house of blues. I was cold and I was hungry. All too short on money. Not too well. But what the hell, I'm still living. And this house just ain't no home. I know when I'm alone. And I know just where to go when love is gone. She left me next to nothing. Another broken fool. Standing in the cold wind. The moon. Some were born to win the game. Some were born to live. And they spend the night deep inside the house of blues. She left me next to nothing, another broken fool. Standing in the cold wind, howling at the moon. Some were born to win the game, some were born to lose. And they spend the night,
Yeah, my night in the house of blues. Come on, Chuck. She left me next to nothing, another broken fool. Standing in the cold wind, howling at the moon. Some are born to win the game, some are born to lose. And they spend the nights, every night in the house of blues. Lord, every day. Every day and every night, will they waste their lives every night in the house of blues?
Somebody clapping up in northern Minnesota. Thank you for that. Appreciate it. That is awesome.
Probably Brainerd.
Yes.
Is that a person or is that a place?
That's a place.
Hopefully, you know, we're all from all over the place. I'm from Crookston, Minnesota. It's a little town up north. Hopefully some folks are watching, maybe some old classmates, who knows, relatives. Hey, we have another Crookstonite. Patty Knox is in the crowd. There she is. Say, there we go. We have people from Nashville natives. Where are you from, Holly? Missouri.
Missouri.
Pittsburgh. We got Pittsburgh represented back here on bass guitar. Clarksville, Tennessee. Marshall Pearson on the drums. Joe Lamont.
Chicago, Illinois.
Hey, Chicago, can I say? I'm not sure if that's how they talk in Chicago. I just made
it's
that
not.
No, I was close. It's not even close.
Via Moline.
But yeah, sure, you betcha. That's how they talk up there in Minnesota. I'll tell you right now. That's somewhat authentic, by the way. Oh, we have someone watching in Georgia. Your niece, Marshall. Very good. Hey, guys, let's move on. Let's feature Mr. from Pittsburgh here, Gary Link.
My name's Gary.
Gary.
Hey, I want to shout out to my one-year-old grandson, Miller.
Miller!
Happy birthday, buddy.
Today?
Yes.
How old is he?
One.
One. He's one.
He's one.
Awesome. All right, let's dedicate.
He's a beast.
Let's dedicate this to him. It's Driving Wheel.
There you go. That's it.
That's it.
Driving Miller. Come on. My baby don't have to work. You don't have to rob and steal. My baby don't have to work. She don't have to rob and steal. I give her everything she needs, 'cause I'm her driving wheel. Well, she left me this morning. She said she'd be back soon. Well, she left me this morning, and she said she'd be back soon. Talking about early, Friday Maybe late Saturday afternoon.
I don't think so, baby. Come on.
Heaven down here is the wind of change. Clouds roll in from the north and start to rain. It rained real hard and it rained for a real long time. And there was 6 feet of water in the streets of Evangeline. River rolls on Jay, river rolls on night. Some people got lost in the flood. Other folks, they got away all right. River busted through, clear down the flag of mine. And there was 6 feet of water, streets of Evangeline. Louisiana. Louisiana, yeah, they're trying to wash us away. Oh, they're trying to wash us away. Louisiana, Louisiana, yeah, they're trying to wash us away. Oh, Gary Gilbert now. see President Coolidge came down on a railroad train with a little fat man with a notepad in his hand. And the president said, little man, ain't it a shame? The river's gone to this poor farmer's land. Louisiana, Louisiana, yeah, they're trying to wash us away. Oh, they're trying to wash us away. Louisiana, Louisiana, yeah, they're trying to wash us away. Get me out of here.
That's Joe's cousin from Colorado.
Bettendorf, Iowa.
You just piped in. Hey, if you've got something to say, I'm kind of watching you. I'd like to say hello to you, so feel free to put a comment on there. So something nice would be good. You know, I mean, there's no need for ugliness now. Come on. We have Kevin and Diane. Where are they at? They're in Florida. Kevin and Diane. I mean, longtime Beaker Street supporters in Florida. Are they watching? That's awesome. Hello. Very good. All right. Hey, we're going to keep things rolling here. See if you remember this one.
Cool, Kevin. Kevin responds to every Facebook thing.
Cool.
Because he is the coolest guy in the world.
Southland in a trapline minstrel show. Yes, I would love to tune in something in a traveling minstrel show. I have never met Napoleon, but I plan to find the time, find the time. Never met Napoleon, but I plan to find the time. Yes, I do.
Look so fine upon that hill. They tell me he is lonely, lonely as hell. I'm standing on forever, over a long time ago.
Oh, oh yeah, oh yeah. On a platform, the man gave me the news. He said, you must be joking. Where did you get those shoes, boy? Where did you get them shoes? Get them shoes.
Well, I see them on the TV, the movie show. They say the time is changing, but I just don't know.
The mail helping us out on a vocal on that.
Yeah, hey, how about I, America, Canada, everywhere? How about a nice round of applause for Mel? Hey, we hear you clapping. Mel's. We'll bring Mel up again to sing with us later. All right, here comes Holly now. Let's bring Holly up to the microphone. Here's the microphone, Holly.
Let me have it. chokes me up every time. This is a song about a girlfriend I once had. Or should I say, she once had me. Okay, let me count it off. Can I count it off? One, two, three. Well, just because you're pretty, you think your body wise. You tell me that you love me, and you roll those big brown eyes. Well, I saw you last week, and your eyes were turning black. Go ask that guy that beat you up, and ask him to take you back. Don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on a spree. Well, I know that you're lying when you say that you've been crying. So don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me. Well, I used to spend my money just to make you look real sweet. So I would be proud of you as we walk down the street. Now don't ask me to dress you up in satin or in silk, cause your eyes look like two cherries in a glass of buttermilk. Don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on a spree. Well, I know that you're lying when you say that you've been crying. So don't roll bloodshot eyes at me. Our little romance has finally simmered down. You ought to join a circus, cause you'd make a real good clown. My eyes look like a roadmap, and I'm scared to smell your breath. You better shut your peepers before you bleed to death. Don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me. I can tell that you've been out on the spree. Well, I know that you're lying when you say that you've been crying. So don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me. Well, I know that you're lying when you say that you've been crying. So don't roll those bloodshot eyes at me.
Someone's gonna have to tell an incredibly funny joke right now because I have to go change out a battery, so I'll be right back.
Hey, Ava Ray, you having a good time out there, baby? That's my granddaughter. Love you, baby.
I want to shout out to my son, Les, who's where's he at tonight, Mom? In Sandpoint, Idaho. He was there last year.
Shout out to Murphy over there in England. Murph, love you, man. Hope to see you sometime soon.
And let's see.
We don't have any friends. It's kind of.
There's a. Because of Linda. Hey, Linda.
All right. Did anything fall apart while I was away?
Nothing happened.
Hey, I got one more shout out to my friend Ray Vasquez and the Men in Blue. All right. Thanks for what you guys do.
Yeah. Love you, man.
Hey, here we go. Holly, you got a note. Hey. He loves you.
Vince Emmett, George Cochini.
Okay, Tom Steffen just came on from Elk Mound, Wisconsin. Okay, a little quick history. So Tom and I were in the very first band ever, like in high school. Tom was our guitar player and had a velvety kind of Roy Orbison kind of waist. Tom Steffen from Crookston, Minnesota. Way to go, Tom. Nice to see you, man. Oh, my gosh. That was fun. So keep the comments coming. We'd love to hear from you. What? Oh, who said that? Oh, thank you. That's really nice. Somebody, we remind someone of Rare Earth, but he thinks we're better. Is that what he said? Send him $100. Kevin Sullivan, cool. Kevin, there you go. Kevin Wilkerson, I saw you a little bit a while ago. How you doing, Kevin? Mike Welch, what's going on? Joe Midler out there in California. Who else is? We got to see some more people. Keep popping up. What are we doing, guys? Hey, how about some Ray Charles? That's very good. Let's do it.
Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through, just an old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. I said, Georgia, sweet Georgia, there ain't no peace I find. Come as sweet and clear moonlight through the pine. Other arms reach out to me. Other eyes, they smile tenderly. Still and peaceful dreams I see. The road leads back, yeah. I said, Georgia, Georgia, sweet Georgia, there ain't no peace I find. Come as sweet and clear keeps Georgia on my mind. He said before we met that your life was awful tame. Well, I took you to a nightclub and the whole band knew your name. Yeah, well, baby, it's true. But I'll tell you, little woman, I've got news for you. Well, somehow your story just don't ring true. Baby, I
good for you. You told me to be late. Said you took the wrong express. And then you walked in smiling with your lipstick all on a mess. Well, well, baby, I'm gonna tell you, little woman, I've got news for you. Well, somehow your time just won't do. Baby, I've got news for you. Little woman, I've got news for you. Well, somehow your time just won't do. Baby, I've got news for you. Well, somehow your time just won't do.
Gary Gilbert, the King Bee, he's got news for you. We got straight Everclear. Oh my God. We're real blues guys. Oh, shucks. Dasani, that's Everclear, right? All right. Hey, for all you folks, well, maybe more folks, but I always give a shout out to this particular band because they influenced me so heavily back in the 60s when I was a young high school punk playing rock and roll. And we would go up in northern Minnesota to Mentor, Minnesota, to the Maple Lake Pavilion. And, of course,
every band that ever played there every Sunday night was amazing. But my favorite was the Fabulous Flippers. And yes, Fabulous Flippers. And we, this is their signature song. They recorded this. They had a nice regional hit with it. But here's our version of the Fabulous Flippers tune. You guys ready? Hang on to your hats, America, Canada, everywhere. Here's a Harlem Shuffle.
You move to the left, yeah you do, you really do. You move to the right, if it takes all night. Come on, baby, with a whole lot of soul. Move with your body real slow, yeah. I say you stretch. Just like a monkey, yeah you do, you really do. And whoa, to the limber, how low can you go? Come on, baby, and do the ride, ride the pony ride, yeah, 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 do the Harlem Shuffle. Under the mud, yeah, 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 yeah. Do the Harlem Shuffle. Say you hitchhike, baby, across the floor. Yeah. One is enough. I can't take it no more. Come on, baby, and do the fly and ride, ride that pony ride. Yeah, 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 yeah. To the Harlem Shuffle, under the monkey, yeah, 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 yeah. To the Harlem Shuffle. Oh, yeah.
And Joe Lamont.
For Sarah.
All right. Does anybody know how to do the monkey?
I do.
There we go. Is that the monkey?
That's the monkey.
Wow, that's pretty good.
You do the monkey now, yeah.
That's good. You folks online, just do the monkey on your own. Send us videos, please.
Yes, please.
Love to see that.
No, no, don't send it in.
Hey, Peggy Newhouse from San Diego. Peggy, what's happening? There you are. What a blast. Great song, she said. Thanks, Peggy. Patty says hi. All right. Patty and Peggy, old buddies from high school.
Shout out to Shrewsbury.
Shrewsbury.
Shrewsbury, Ontario. Hope to fish this year, but I don't know. Jim Davenport's online. Jim. Thanks, man.
All right.
Also, got to send one out to Kirsten Amell, great drummer from Ontario. Hope you're watching, buddy. Sorry you're not at work, but.
Marvin Smith watching in Alabama. Anybody know Marvin? Marvin. Marvin Smith.
Yeah. Marvin. How you doing, Marvin? The truck runs great. The trailer's beautiful. We're having a great time. Wish you were here.
Jim Davenport.
Diane, you too. Miss you.
Hey, without that, let's move on here. And here comes King B one more time, a little bit Elvis King, let me say.
Yeah! Let's have a natural ball. Let's do it.
Well, if you don't rock and roll, won't be no fun at all. Won't you love me in the morning, late at night? Don't be jealous, woman, everything's all right. Come on, baby, let's have a natural ball. Well, if you don't boogie woogie, won't be my fault at all. Ball. If you don't boogie woogie, it won't be my fault at all. Won't you love me in the morning, love me at noon, love me at night, take you to the moon. Come on, baby, let's have a natural ball. Well, if you don't rock and roll, it won't be no fun at all. Come on now.
Near the street door, black roof country, no gold payments, diet stalling, silver horses ran down the moonbeams in your dark eyes. The night smiles on you leaving my picture. In this place where the sun never shines, way in this place where the devil comes. You said no dream could secure you at the speed of dawn. Platform ticket, rest is diesel, goodbye window. I walked in too. Such a sad time at the street. As I walked out, felt my own need just begin.
Gary Show, Gary Gilbert on guitar, Gary Link on the vocals. Woo!
Oh, yeah. Jack, oh, sorry, Jack. You can never do it like Jack, man. What do you think?
Well, I'll tell you. So, if you haven't figured out by now, we do anything that's blues and or blues influenced, and it's really great to shout out to the British blues rockers and, of course, Cream and Eric Clapton and Joe Cocker and, you know, so many bands. It had great big hits, were influenced by blues, and we started out as a straight-ahead, flat-out only blues band, but we've sort of been picking some of these little nuggets now to squeeze in, and if they've got blues influence, we're interested. This next tune, you know, Cream is certainly one of my favorite bands growing up also, but a little later on came this group, that we just love, and we worked up a song by them. This one by Blood, Sweat, and Tears. Yeah, we'll send this out to who, Joe?
The best piano player in Pine Grove, Alabama, Marvin Smith. Pine Hill, Alabama. Put your hands together for Marvin Smith.
God bless the child.
Your gift while the weak ones lose. So the Bible says, and it still is new, that mama may have and papa may have. God bless the child that's got his own well. Got his own. And the strong seem to get more, while the weak ones fade. Empty pockets don't ever make the grave. Mama may have, and papa may have. God bless the child that's got his own. Well, that's got his own. And when you got money, you got lots of friends crowding round your door. And when the money's gone, and all your spending is, they won't be around anymore. No, no, no. And rich relations may toss you across the go on and help yourself, but don't take too much, cause mama may have, and papa may have. God bless the child that's got his own, that's got his own. When you got money, You got lots of friends crowding round your door. Wait a minute, people, when the money's gone and all your spending is, they won't be round anymore. No, 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 no. And rich relations may toss you a crust of bread and such. Go on and help yourself, but don't take too much. Mama may have, and Papa may have. God bless the child who can say, I got my own.
More songs, don't go anywhere. If you're just joining us, thanks for coming on. I know sometimes people come and go and whatever, but we are really tickled pink to have this opportunity to play for anyone who's listening online. We really appreciate it. Be sure to visit our website if you're interested in the CD, or we have a tip jar set up there also if you're interested in supporting the band. That'd be fine. BeakerStreetBluesBand.com, that's the only plug I got. Please like us on Facebook. That's the most important thing, so we can stay in touch with you guys, because we plan on doing more of these, see how the response is. But we've been having a great time doing it. We're not playing out live very much these days, but we can do it right here, and we'll just keep improving it, try to get it better and do some more. Let's do one called Stuff You Gotta Watch.
Know the girl you love, she don't treat you right sometimes. You know the girl you love, she don't treat you right sometimes. Well, that's the stuff you gotta watch, because your girl is a liar. You know the girl you love, she stays out all night long.
Should be mine.
Yeah, the girl you love, she stays out all night long.
Should be mine.
Well, that's the stuff you gotta watch, because your girl's treating you wrong. I need my hat, I need my coat, along with that, baby, you don't want to have to go with that.
Stuff you gotta watch.
Stuff you gotta watch.
Stuff you gotta watch.
Stuff you gotta watch if you don't wanna lose your girl. Hey, hey. No good, but you don't make no change.
Should be mine.
Ah, the girl's no good, but you don't make no change.
Should be mine.
That's good, you gotta watch, cause you're justified all the same. You spend your dope, you drink your gin, and then you go to the phone, and then you spend your dope.
Gotta watch.
That's the stuff you gotta watch.
Stuff you gotta watch.
That's the stuff you gotta watch if you don't wanna lose your girl.
wanna do is your girl.
That's the stuff you gotta watch if you don't wanna lose your girl. I say that's the stuff you gotta watch if you don't wanna lose your girl.
Marsha Pearson singing, Jumpin' Joe on the piano. He was a jumpin'. All right, hey folks, we're coming down to, we got a couple here, but we're gonna take you down and do a little New Orleans music now. We delve into that too. We've got some others, but we're gonna do this one. Personal favorite, and one I picked up on when I worked there as a young musician back in 76 and 7, and was taught a little bit about Louis Prima when I was down there. Let's do a shout out. Here's one called Jump, Jive and Wail. Wrong song. Okay, America, Canada, the world, you just witnessed a meltdown. How'd you like that? Okay, we got any drummers in the house? Marshall's out. But you know what's funny is I just saw somebody post on here, pay the drummer more. Somebody actually said that. I'm not kidding. I read that here a little bit ago. So that's out.
One more chance.
Baby, baby, looks like it's gonna hurt. I said, baby, baby, looks like it's gonna hurt. You better get outside, you better learn how to jive and wail. Well, you gotta jump jiving, then you way you gotta jump jiving. Anyway, 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 the way.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Papa's in the icebox looking for a can of beer. Yeah, Papa's in the icebox looking for a can of beer. Yeah, Mama's out back, she learned how to jive and wail. Well, you gotta jump jiving, anyway, you gotta jump jiving, anyway, you gotta jump jiving, anyway, you gotta jump jiving. Anyway, you gotta jump jiving. Anywhere away.
Oh, yeah.
A woman is a woman and a man ain't nothing but milk. A woman is a woman and a man ain't nothing but a milk. Well, come on, boys, I think we need to learn how to jive and wail. Well, you gotta jump jiving, then you ain't gotta jump jiving, then you ain't gotta jump jiving, then you ain't gotta jump jiving. Anyway, you gotta jump jiving, anywhere the way.
Jumpin' Joe.
Jumpin' Joe.
go.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to get a pail. Well, Jack and Jill went up the hill to get a pail. You know, Jill came down, she learned how to jive and win. Well, you gotta jump jiving, then anyway, 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 you gotta jump jiving.
A wrap for us, guys. One more. Well, okay, the crowd in the place wants one more, but I need one comment on Facebook that says one more, and we'll play one more song. So I'm waiting to see one more. Up the Jeopardy theme music, please. Somebody online needs to say one more, and we will play one more. Did we get a one more?
Tina says one more.
Tina in Cincinnati says one more. Okay. Freebird. We'll play Freebird, but that's $10,000.
Yes, a bird. $10,000 for me.
And you can't do that. FCC regulations state that you cannot.
Okay, here we go. Okay, we got one more. See, we're easy. It just takes one person to go, please play one more song.
Actually, we just play a minute.
We were going to do it anyway.
You don't have to.
All right, guys. Hey, this is a fun song. So we, a good buddy of ours, especially Marshall and myself, we used to play with this. The guy who wrote this song, Pat Upton, Marshall and I played with him a lot, and he had a big hit. He wrote one of the biggest nuggets of all time, and everybody's going to recognize this song. It's one of the feel-good tunes. I've been very fortunate. I know two guys who wrote maybe the two best feel-good songs ever. A good friend of mine in the Turtles wrote Happy Together. We're not doing that one, but we are doing this one that Pat Upton wrote, and he was with a group called The Spiral Staircase, and it goes like this. I love you more today than yesterday. Come on now.
Yeah, and I think you might need some help from the females out there because your range is, this is in your range. Here we go.
Remember what day it was.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know what time it was. All I know is that I fell in love with you. And if all my dreams come true, I'll be spending time with you. Every day's a new day in love with you. There comes a new way of loving you. Every time I kiss your lips, my mind starts to wonder. And if all my dreams come true,
I'll be spending time with you. Stay away. Cupid, we don't need you. Now go on your way. I thank the Lord for love like ours that grows ever stronger. And I always will be true. I know you feel the same way too.
Thank you so much. Thank you all who joined us on Facebook. A nice shout out to Jim Parker, our audio engineer today. Thank you, Jim. Made us sound good. Thank you, John Reitmeyer, our host and pre-show radio personality. John and I go back a couple of years, maybe back to high school. Say it's 10 years ago. Hey, John. Thanks, John. John ran the cameras. Well, he didn't run the cameras. Actually, we had Cynthia running the cameras. Cynthia Lamont, as Joe's wife.
Love you, baby.
We're all in-house. John was our producer of the show for today up at his farm in Minnesota. He produced the whole thing and picked our camera shots. We've had a nice united effort here to make these concerts happen, so we hope to do another one in a month or so. But thank you so much. We are the Beaker Street Blues Band, y'all. Good night. Thanks.
All right, there you have it. What a show it's been tonight, huh? We're going to slowly shut down most of the cameras here. And as we do that, Chuck, as he gets his saxophone and stuff put away, has promised us that he is going to come over, and we're going to talk to him. And if you have any questions, you are welcome to join in there. There he is. I think we're going to get him here. Chuck, hello, can you hear me? Unplug the, so you're just on the computer. Now you should be just on the computer. Nope, still no here.
Now you can hear me.
There we go.
Yeah, okay. Hey, is this the interview portion of the show?
This is the interview. Hello, Doc Severinsen. How are you? And welcome to the show.
Well, that was great fun. Thanks, John, for doing that. We got lots of commotion here you're hearing in the background, but all 10 of us, 15, I don't know. Small crowd.
It was a great show. The sound was great. Boy, the camera people were just having a good time today. We got, you know, the close-up.
Hang on, my hat is dripping. Hang on.
The close-up shots of Joe playing the keyboard and the guitars. Everybody's commenting on the drummer's shirt for some reason. You got to start selling shirts for the
drummer. Let me check that out. Hang on a second. That is a nice one. I haven't seen that before. Marshall, come in here a second.
Yeah. Yeah,
people sure did like your shirt today.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one guy said he wanted to go bowling with me. This is his own special line. These are available at www.marshall.com. We'll get these shirts. And a good one.
Okay, just so, okay. All right.
You know that 10% of all the profits goes to the old bluesman's home in Columbia, Tennessee, to support all the old guys at the nursing home there to buy tobacco. Hey, wow, I didn't know you could spin a trumpet like that. That was pretty darn cool there.
You're a showman. This guy's a showman, I'm telling you.
Wow, yeah, lots of fun. Oh, D.D. Clark Grokey says, I love the shirt. Stuart Snyder, thank you, John. Thank you.
What about this? Come on.
Hey, it looks like what they're making masks out of up here for coronavirus.
Anyway. Oh my God. Well, that was great fun.
It was really good. We had a lot of fun today. We had a lot of fun.
Well, I guess we'll sign off for now, but thanks again, anybody who's still watching, and thanks for coming out and watching us play and be goofy and have a good time.
It was great. Any idea when we're going to see this again? Is there any idea when this might happen?
Yeah, if there was a demand, we would do it once a month. So we're waiting to see. I don't know. We could pull it off once a month. It would be really fun. So we have plans. If we do start doing it that often, we'll, of course, have some new. Well, we've got a lot of songs.
Where'd you go? I lost you. Wow. At that exact moment, Chuck Schumacher decided to freeze himself. We've lost you, Chuck. Are you there in any variation? And I guess that's why we have control on this end, folks, is that for some reason somebody pulled one extra cord down there. Kevin Sullivan says, cool, and thank you very much. Hi, John. Hi, Chuck. Hi, Vicky. Wow. Vicky, great to catch up with you. Man, I remember playing billiards in your mother and father's basement there in the pool table a long time ago. Cold-blooded Joe, Vicky Grieve says. All. By the way, when this is all over, the guys sit down and they read all the comments through. From top to bottom. So just to let you know, we'll see if Marshall's camera is still on, if anybody figures that out. But otherwise, we have lost the connection down there, but we're still live here just in time, I guess, to say goodbye to you. Thank you all for listening. It has been just a wonderful time, and this is so fun to do. Who would have thought those young kids that went up to Canada back in 1971, 1972, and we're just awestruck by the talent that we saw. Got to play with some of the really finer people across Canada, Alan Drusco, Murray Irving. Chuck went on to play with just loads and loads of people and then ended up in New Orleans for some years where he really developed his chops. I went more into the business side of things, and we've just had fun in the music business all along the way. So for Father's Day tomorrow, we hope that if you are a father, congratulations. Hope you enjoy some time with your siblings. Siblings, what am I talking about? Your offspring, your protege. Protege? Progeny. Progeny would be the right word. I hope your progeny are protege. And for all you youngins, stop by and say hi to your dads. Check in with them. We'll see you again. Stay tuned to the Beaker Street Blues Band Facebook page. That's where you'll find out everything you need to know about coming events. Tom Steffen, good to see you. I still remember you and your bass guitar out there in the countryside south of Crookston. Vicky, Peggy, Kevin, all the people up here on the comments section. Like I said, the band stops and they'll go through all the comments. Feel free to catch up with them in the different ways that you can on the different chat rooms and things. So from northern Minnesota, where we had rain and thunderstorms and lightning through the whole session today, but everything held for us. God's blessings to all of you, and we look forward to seeing you again real soon.